far as we can tell, at 8:40 this morning, every single child in the world stopped.
Right, where is Star? What are we looking for?
Everyone in the office seems to think what's happening with the kids is all to do with aliens.
Wait! Tell me, is it going to have they come back?
What's happening again?
That's what everyone seems to be asking. When were they here before?
You never told me. I was never a part of it.
We need that whole team out of the way by tonight. Get it done.
Target one's eliminated. Two and three have escaped, but we're in pursuit.
If he talks, we're in deep, deep shit.
What civil servant are you?
But I appreciate it, but...
DVD from BBC Video, which you have either bought, borrowed, or stolen. Although, if you stole this, then let's pause for a moment to think about what you've done. If you enjoy the kind of programme that you're about to experience once I eventually stop talking, we thought you might be interested to know that numerous other quality British programmes are available to you on the US cable network BBC America. Britain produces dramas like Puerto Rico produces Shortstops. When you take a class-ridden society with no ability to address its emotions and let it simmer for 1,000 years, you frankly have the perfect recipe for drama. British comedies have struck a chord with American viewers for decades. At the very least, you seem to find our accent absolutely hilarious. And we haven't even mentioned the news yet. Ah, now we have. BBC America also has outstanding news programming that brings a global perspective to the stories Americans care about. Ah, it makes me proud to be British. So why not tune in to BBC America and let us entertain you in the manner to which you are no longer accustomed. Not only is this an unmissable opportunity for you to hear words pronounced correctly, but you can also watch some of the finest programmes available. And all for the low, low price of absolutely no money whatsoever. Thank you for your time. Enjoy your DVD.
British national.
My name's Mark Brighton, British ambassador here in Washington. I just wanted to say
I'm sorry.
Ambassador, the US Secretary of Defense, Lynn Warner.
If I die, you are screwed.
I don't want to say goodbye.
My son did not die in Afghanistan so that our so-called allies can blow themselves up in our own backyard.
I need you to help me stop Warner from engineering a